Hey there, viewers. Skin cancer is one of the most common forms of cancer in the United States. At least 1 in 5 people get skin cancer in their lives. When your skin is exposed to ultraviolet radiation, mainly from sunlight, the cell's DNA could get damaged. Because of this, there could be mutations and an abnormal growth in your skin cells, which multiply quickly to become malignant. In today's video, we'll be discussing skin cancer, its signs, symptoms, treatment, and preventative measures you can undertake. How many types of skin cancer are there? Can you stop them? We'll be discussing all of this and more. Types of skin cancer. There are 2 types of skin cancer, carcinoma and melanoma. While there are other types of skin lesions that could potentially become cancerous, they're not treated as skin cancer until they mutate. Number 1. Basal cell carcinoma. Basal cells are present within the skin and produce new cells as old ones die. Basal cell carcinoma is the most common type of skin cancer. They make up as much as 80% of cancer cases. This type of cancer usually shows up on your face or neck, the parts of the body most exposed to the sunlight. It appears like a white lump or a brown scaly patch. Basal cell carcinoma is a curable type of cancer. It doesn't typically spread to other parts of your body, but if you don't get it treated, it can destroy your skin, tissues, and even bone. It can even stop a particular part of your body from functioning. Do you self-examine your skin? Have you ever noticed brown patches or white lumps? What did you do? Share your experiences with the Bestie community in the comments below. Number 2. Squamous cell carcinoma. Squamous cell carcinoma is the second most frequent type of skin cancer. This type also occurs on your body parts exposed to UV radiation from sunlight and tanning beds. Squamous cell carcinoma, unlike basal cells, can spread to other parts of your body. Although cancer cells grow at a much slower rate, they can appear in multiple parts of your body like your head, neck, chest, arms, and legs. Squamous cell carcinoma is also curable. It usually appears as red, scaly lesions on the skin. Number 3. Melanoma. Melanoma only occurs in about 1% of skin cancer cases, but it's the more dangerous form. If not detected early, it can be fatal. While it is rare, it makes up the majority of skin cancer deaths each year. Melanoma begins in melanocytes, the pigment that gives your skin its color. The type of cancer can occur in any parts of the body. That being said, melanoma will likely first develop on the chest and back of men and the legs of women. Other common sites include your neck and face. You would think having darkly pigmented skin would reduce your risk of melanoma, and you're partly right. Your risk does decrease, but only on more common sites like the chest, back, and legs. Anyone can get melanoma on their hands, feet, and even under their nails. Number 4. Less common types of skin cancer. There are other less common types of skin cancer like Kaposi sarcoma. This type develops from the cells that line your blood vessels. It appears as tumors on your skin or inside your mouth, lungs, and even your digestive tract. Merkel cell carcinoma. As the name suggests, this type of cancer starts in the Merkel cells of your skin. Now, what are Merkel cells? These are cells that are found at the base or top layer of your skin. They share some features with hormone cells and nerve cells. This type of cancer spreads quickly and can be quite difficult to treat once it starts multiplying. Cutaneous lymphoma. More popularly known as lymphoma of the skin, this type starts in special white blood cells, which are the basic unit of your immune system. These white blood cells are called lymphocytes. They're small, bean-sized immune cells in your body. You'll find them in your lymph nodes and tissues like the spleen, bone marrow, and skin. Skin adnexal tumors. These are simply tumors that start in your hair follicles or skin glands. Before we move ahead, here's another video you might like. Watch and learn more about the 10 body changes that need your immediate attention. What causes skin cancer? Number 1. UV light from the sun and tanning beds. We just learned how the UV light from the sun can harm your skin. But that's not the only way you can get skin cancer. Apart from exposure to sunlight, another source of UV radiation is a tanning bed. If you expose your skin to tanning beds while getting fake tans, it could cause damage to the skin cells. This damage to the skin cells can mutate into cancer. Number 2. Cancer-causing chemicals. These chemicals are another reason behind skin cancers like carcinoma. Moles are generally benign, but sometimes turn malignant and cause melanoma. Your body doesn't need to be exposed to UV radiation for you to get melanoma. It occurs in parts of your body that typically aren't hit by the sunlight. Signs and symptoms of skin cancer. Number 1. Open sore. One of the biggest red flags associated with skin cancer is an open sore that won't heal. If the sore keeps bleeding but doesn't heal completely, it's a sign of carcinoma. Open wounds such as this can be aggressive and quickly turn into skin cancer. Number 2. Pink bumps. Another sign of skin cancer, particularly carcinoma, is a pink bump on your skin. Sometimes it can also be in the form of a reddish or brown flat patch on your skin. Number 3. Asymmetrical moles. Melanoma can be identified if you have a mole that's asymmetrical. You can check for melanoma using the ABCDE method, which stands for asymmetry, irregular border, color variations, diameter greater than 6 millimeters, and elevated surface. Itching and bleeding is another indication. Treatments of skin cancer. Number 1. Cryotherapy. In cryotherapy, an extreme cold solution like liquid nitrogen is used to freeze the part of the skin that's affected. The cancer cells are fenced in by the ice crystals. The tissue is then removed as the skin thaws. One study showed around 97% of non-melanoma cancers were successfully treated using cryotherapy. It's a safe and low-cost method to treat skin cancer. Number 2. Excision surgery. An excisional surgery is when the part of the skin with the cancer growth will be cut out, along with some healthy skin around it. This is usually done for moles and lesions, but tumors can also be removed in a similar manner. Number 3. Mohs surgery. This is a very effective treatment that can sometimes be successful for melanoma. In this surgery, each layer of cancer growth is removed and examined under a microscope. This procedure continues until no more abnormal cells can be detected. It's best used for situations where conserving the tissue is important, and also in cases where the chances of a reoccurrence are high. Number 4. Chemotherapy. This is an aggressive drug treatment which seeks to destroy the cancer-growing cells in your body. But there are some side effects, including hair loss, diarrhea, and weight loss. This treatment is used along with other forms of therapy and ensures the cancer doesn't spread any further. If your cancer is detected at a later stage, chemotherapy can also be used for pain relief. Number 5. Radiation. Radiation therapy is a form of treatment where focused radiation beams are used to destroy cancer cells. It also comes with side effects such as hair loss and fatigue. This treatment is so intensive and lasts up to 10 weeks on a nearly daily basis. One radiation session can last up to 30 minutes. It's primarily used for cases in which the cancer is in an advanced stage. It's also used in cases where the tumor cells need to be reduced before surgery. Prevention. Honestly, there's no sure way of preventing skin cancer, but you can do certain things to reduce your risk, like limit your exposure to the sun, as well as tanning beds. Other measures you can take include wearing good quality sunscreen, staying in the shade whenever possible, wearing hats, sunglasses, and full-sleeved clothing, avoiding tanning beds or sun lamps, watching for abnormal moles to help detect skin cancer at an early stage. Cancer is one of the most challenging diseases. The scary part is we don't know what causes it. You can only rely on early detection and preventative methods, like stop eating foods that increase your risk. Watch 12 cancer-causing foods you shouldn't eat. You can also try 8 common cancer signs that are almost always ignored. Go ahead and click one. Better yet, watch both and learn more about how to prevent cancer. Did you know about these skin cancer signs before watching this video? Let us know in the comments below.